Assalamu alaikum. Today's topic is unit number 5, book exercise from page 50 to 52. Class 9, subject English. Book for class 9. First of all, we will revise common noun and proper noun for solving a book exercise. What is common noun? The word commonly used for a person, animal, place or a thing of same kind is called a common noun. Common noun is used for common things. Examples: boy, chair, cat, computer, city. These are the name of common things. Now proper noun. The word used for particular person, animal, place or thing is called a proper noun. It always begins with capital letter. Holy Quran, it is proper noun. Karachi, Sadia, Punjab, Islam. These are proper noun. Now coming to book exercise. Tell whether each of the following noun is a common noun or a proper noun. For each common noun, write a related proper noun. For each proper noun, write a related common noun. Example, leader. Answer, leader, common noun, Qaid-e-Azam, proper noun. Author. Author is common noun. So, Shakespeare will be its proper noun. Mountain, it is common noun. Mount Everest will be proper noun. Teacher, common noun. Mr. Ali is proper noun. Professor Kamal, proper noun. Professor, it will be its common noun. Building, it is common noun. What will be its proper noun? Building of State Bank. Eid, it is common noun. What will be its proper noun? Eidul Azha. Park, it is common noun. What will be its proper noun? National Park. Friend, it is common noun. What will be its proper noun? Faiza. City, it is common noun. What will be its proper noun? Karachi. River, it is common noun. What will be its proper noun? River Indus. Islamia College, it is proper noun. What will be its common noun? College. France, it is proper noun. What will be its common noun? City. Country. Karachi, it is proper noun. What will be its common noun? City. Hero, it is common noun. What will be its proper noun? Qaid-e-Azam. Boy, it is common noun. What will be its proper noun? Ali. So now, I have written common noun as CN on the words and you have to write down it in a proper way. You have to draw a margin line and on one side you have to write common noun and on the other side you have to write its proper noun. Now coming to collective noun. The word used for the group of people or thing is called collective noun. The word which is used for the group of people, you have to keep in your mind, the word which is used for the group of people, the word which is used for the group of people or things is called collective noun. Examples, class. Class, it is the group of students. String, it is the collection of fiber which make a string. String means dhaga, dori, rassi. Team, the group of players. Army, group of soldiers. Fleet, group of ships. So the group of things or people is termed as collective noun. Identify the collective noun in the following sentences and use them in new sentences. The staff quickly responded to the alarm. So the staff is the group of employees. So staff is the word which shows the collective noun. The audience stood up and cheered the speaker. The audience, samain, sunne wale. So it is collective noun. Suddenly the class became very quiet. Class, group of students. Class is collective noun. The board met last night to vote on the budget. Board is a group of heads, Sarbarahan. So board is collective noun. Her family is going to Nathia Gali this weekend. Family, the group of members in the family. So family is a collective noun. So staff, audience, class, board, families, these are collective noun. Now coming to make plural of the following nouns and identify which of the nouns also change meaning in plural. So there are some of nouns when we make its plural, so it changes its meaning. So first of all we will make its plural and find out that whether it change its meaning or not. Arm, when we put s with arm and make its plural, so it change its meaning. Arms means weapon. First word arm means part of body and arms means weapon. So there is a word arm which changes its meaning when it change into plural form. Brother-in-law, what is its plural? Brothers-in-law. It keeps it meaning. Courtroom, it has the same meaning. Shoelaces, it has the same meaning. Commander-in-chief, commanders-in-chiefs. So in all of these words, only arm is a word. If we change it into plural, it changes its meaning. Now coming to countable noun. What is countable noun? For solving another exercise, we have to revise countable noun. What is countable noun? The naming words which can be counted are called countable noun. The things which can be counted are called countable noun. Examples: pen, book, house, orange, girl. Uncountable noun. The naming words which cannot be counted are called uncountable noun. Just as oil, water, milk, honesty, light. Sort out uncountable nouns from the following and use them in sentences. I will sort out countable and uncountable for you and you have to make its sentences as an activity work. Sugar is uncountable. We cannot count the grains of the sugar. Mango, it is countable noun. Start, it is uncountable noun. You may change this word with salt or with star. All of three are uncountable noun. Flour, atta, uncountable noun. It is weighted, it is not counted. Bread, it is countable noun. Orange, it is countable noun. Milk, anything which is in liquid consistency is also uncountable noun. So milk is uncountable noun. Tea, it is uncountable noun because it has liquid consistency. Chocolate, it is uncountable noun. Candy, it can be counted, so it is countable noun. Now coming to exercise 6, change the following sentences from singular to plural and from plural to singular. Change the sentences into singular and into plural. He is smart boy. It is singular. We have to change it into plural. They are smart boys. Is he a nice character? Singular. We have to change it into plural. Are they nice characters? Is this man a worker? Singular. We have to change it into plural. Are these men workers? Are the bottles on the table? It is in plural. We have to change it into singular. Is the bottle on the table? The pencils are not in the boxes. It is plural. We have to change it into singular. The pencil is not in the box. Now coming to exercise number 7, Rewrite the following sentences by replacing the underlined words with pronouns. What are pronouns? Which are used instead of noun is called pronoun. So, if we write a sentence and if we repeat a noun many times, it will be very awkward. So, let's read this sentence. Okay, first of all, we will read the question. Rewrite the following sentences by replacing the underlined words with pronouns. So, if the sentence comes to you in this way, Fareed planted the cucumber so that Fareed would have the cucumber for salad. So, the word, it is awkward to repeat the noun so many times. So, to reduce the repetition, we use pronoun instead of noun. So, Fareed planted the cucumber so that we will write pronoun. What is the pronoun for Fareed? Pronoun is he. He would have the, what is pronoun for cucumber? It, for salad. So, the sentence would be correctly written as Fareed planted the cucumber so that he would have it for salad. Now coming to the next sentence, the children loved the parrot and taught the parrot singing. The children loved the parrot and taught it singing. So the correct pronoun is it for parrot. When the alarm rang, I turned the alarm off. When the alarm rang, I turned it off. So, the alarm will not be repeated. We will use pronoun for it. Salma washed the peaches and put the peaches in a bowl. Salma washed the peaches and put them in a bowl. That is the watch that Syrah's parents gave Syrah as graduation present. That is the watch that Syrah's parents gave her as graduation present. So, in this exercise, we learn how to use pronoun instead of nouns to reduce the repetition. Now, coming to next exercise, which comprises of antecedent. For this purpose, we will have to see on the slide to know about what is an antecedent. Antecedent definition. It is a word that is replaced by another word in the course of sentence. In most cases, antecedents are replaced by pronoun. In most cases, antecedents are replaced by nouns. In the sentence, when Mary felt unwell, she was rushed to the nearby hospital. Mary is antecedent to the pronoun she. So, it is all the relationship of noun and pronoun. So, Mary is the antecedent to the pronoun she. Understanding the relationship between the two is very important when it comes to mastery of English. In simple terms, an antecedent is a noun that comes before the use of pronoun in a sentence. So, it is very easy. What is antecedent? Antecedent is a noun. It is a naming word of thing, person, place or thing that comes before the use of pronoun in a sentence. So, antecedents comes before the use of noun. In simple words, you can say, if someone asks you what is an antecedent, you can answer it like, an antecedent comes before the use of pronoun in a sentence. It is very easy to understand. Underline the pronoun antecedent in the following sentence. Salma sent Roman the address of the house that he had bought. Salman sent Roman the address of the house that he had bought. So, what is antecedent? It is a noun which is used before the pronoun. So, Salman is antecedent for the pronoun he. So, Salman is antecedent for the pronoun he. The first thing that Mrs. Ali reads in the newspaper is the comic strips that she loves. So Mrs. Ali is antecedent for the pronoun she. When Imran and Salman came in, they were laughing. Imran and Salman is antecedent for the pronoun they. Although the tree lost several branches in the storm, it is still healthy. Tree antecedent, it is pronoun of it. Khurram took down the curtains, Khanam took down the curtains, but she did not have time to wash them. Khanam antecedent, she is pronoun. So what is antecedent? It is a noun which is used before the pronoun is called antecedent. Now coming to filling the blanks with the article a, an, or the with necessary, put across where no article is used. So there are two types of article, as you have learned it in my previous lectures. There are two types of articles. One is called definite article and one is called indefinite article. Indefinite articles comprises of a and an, and definite article comprises of the. Definite article is used for particular things and indefinite article is used for common things. So do you live in dash Peshawar? No article is required over here, so we will put cross over here. He is dash teacher who taught us English. He is the teacher who taught us English. Why we put the definite article? Because it is talking about a particular person. I bought dash umbrella. I bought an umbrella. There is a need of an because we use an before writing a vowel. He has dash lovely cat. He has a lovely cat. Now coming to which of the three sentences containing a modal has the same meaning as the original one. So we have discussed modal auxiliary verb in the previous lectures. What is modal auxiliary verb? The modal auxiliary verbs are can, could, may, might, shall, should, will, would, ought. These are all considered as modal auxiliary verb. So we have to find the same meaning of modal auxiliary verb. She is not able to read Chinese. To show ability, we use which modal auxiliary verb? We use can. So she cannot read Chinese. To show ability, we use can. She cannot read Chinese. Now coming to second statement. Do you think we are allowed to park here? Allowed, give permission, or to allow you for something, we use the word may. Do you think we may park here? This is the correct answer. Do you think we may park here? You don't have to do this exercise. You do not need, it is not necessary for you. So we use the word must. You have to or you don't have to. It is a compulsion, so we used must. You must not do this exercise. When the emphasis is put on something, we use must. We have to stop when the traffic lights are red. We have to again put some emphasis, so we use we must stop when the traffic lights are red. Am I allowed to ask a question? Allowed means may I ask a question. Now coming to regular and irregular verb. A verb following the normal pattern of inflection is called regular verb. For example, reach, reached, reached, or the words which end with ed is called regular verb. What are irregular verb? A verb that does not follow the normal pattern of inflection is called irregular verb. For example, go, went, gone. Find irregular verbs from the following list and use them in sentences. So, watch. Watch is regular. We will make other two form of verbs to make it clear. Watch, watched, watched. The use of ed, so it is termed as regular. Be was been. It is irregular. Have had had. It is irregular verb. Meet, met. It is irregular verb. Put. It is irregular verb. Buy, bought. It is irregular verb. Cook, cooked. It is regular verb. Teach, taught. It is irregular verb. Catch, caught. It is irregular verb. Find, found. It is irregular verb. Answered. It is regular verb. Lose, lost. It is irregular verb. Want, wanted. It is regular verb. Tell, told. It is irregular verb. Set. It is irregular verb. Sorry, it is written regular, but it is irregular verb. Set is irregular verb. Set. It is irregular verb. Win. It is irregular verb. Sell. It is irregular verb. Build. It is irregular verb. Drink. It is irregular verb. Opened. It is regular verb. Now coming to activity. Revise kinds of noun and kinds of pronoun. Thank you.